So hello everyone. Since the last video I decided on going for first person movement, mostly because I like them more, but also it should be less work. I found a nice tutorial series made by Lucky on the topic, so I decided to follow along for the base of the movement system. The entire system is built on the character body 3D Godot node. Moving is quite simple. We just modify the velocity on the X and Z axis based on input and call the function move and slide. Jumping works in a similar way, but we modify the Y velocity instead. I added a 0.3 second coyote time, which is just the timer that ticks down when the player is in air and allows the player to jump for a bit after leaving the ground. The player can run, which lowers the current speed to the running speed. A similar thing happens with crouching, but the player's hitbox and camera position also changes. When the player is running and attempts to crouch, they enter a short sliding state. Currently, sliding on slopes doesn't boost the player's speed, but I will add that later. Now that we have basic player movement, let's look into juice in the form of camera movement. The camera setup is quite complex for this script, but I'll attempt to explain it anyway. The parent node, the neck, is used for a cool mechanic called free looking. Basically, it allows the player to look in a different direction while still going forwards. This mechanic could be useful in my game during chases where the creature is behind the player. The next node is the head, which is used for basic camera function we all know. The one after that are the eyes, which is used for head bobbing. Don't ask about the naming schemes, I didn't come up with them. The head bobbing is controlled by two variables, the bobbing intensity and bobbing speed, both of which change depending on the state of the player. After some calculations, some numbers go through sine functions, and we set the position of the node accordingly. The last node in the camera setup is just called camera manip. It's used to smooth the Y position of the camera while also shifting it based on the current velocity. The camera node is the child of this node, alongside an animation player, which is used for jumping, a landing, and a rolling animation. The landing and rolling animations get triggered when the player lands at certain velocity thresholds. So far the system hasn't been too complicated, so now let's start raycasting. Currently, if you walk into a slight elevation, the player refuses to go on top of it. So let's change that by adding step handling to our player. The current system uses 3 raycasts, 2 for detecting walls and 1 for calculating the step position. These raycasts rotate based on player input so that the player can step on objects in any direction. For a step to occur, some conditions have to be met. The step cast must be colliding, but wall cast 2 shouldn't. The player has to be on the floor and the wall angle must be above 50 degrees. If the requirements are met, the player teleports up to the same Y position as the calculated step position. Great, we can now go on stairs. Keep in mind that this is a terrible approach and I already have thought of a better solution, just didn't have the time to implement it yet. I could stop with the player movement here, but I would like to implement climbing as well. This is again probably overcomplicated, however I couldn't find a single tutorial on this topic. We are using 4 raycasts and a sphere cast for the system. We have a sphere cast for detecting if the player needs to climb onto something. Climb cast 2 is there to check if the wall isn't too high for the player to climb. Climb cast 3 calculates the climb position, similarly to how step cast worked for steps. The 2 extra rays, climb cast 4 and 5, are used to check for ceilings above the player. Without it, the player could go through ceilings, which certainly isn't ideal. The current system is quite janky even with these, so rework is necessary in the future, but it's good enough for now. When all of the conditions are met, the player teleports up just like in the step handling system. I added a half a second timer so that the player couldn't glitch up on ledges. And yeah, with all of these mechanics combined, I managed to create a decent little player controller. I will keep working on this sometime, but for next week I want to experiment with terrain generation as it's quite an important part of the game. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next week.